let's begin the next set for map location. We'll be talking about 20 important locations for today. The first important location is Panamik. Now, most of the locations that we would be focusing in this class and the next class talks about hot springs. So this is one of the major hot springs in Nubra Valley, that is close to the Siachen Glacier, and it's one of the sulfur hot springs that are seen. So a very important location. The next is Kheer Ganga. Now Kheer Ganga is again one of the major hot springs, but this is seen in the region of Kullu in Himachal Pradesh. So again an important location. You have Madurai. The temple of Meenakshi Sundareswar is being recognized as one of the Swachh iconic places and the best Swachh iconic places of India. So again very important. So as we have been talking about, we are picking up important locations from Yojana Kurukshetra down to our geography and you for your map location series, and many of those are part of your prelims question paper as well as your mains optional map location. So these locations are indeed very, very important, the place where they are located. So the Meenakshi Sundareswar temple at Madurai. You have Meja forest. Meja forest is known for blackbugs, and this is a division in Allahabad. So in the region of Allahabad division in Uttar Pradesh, you have this blackbug conservation reserve which has been set up, and this has nearly a population of 350 plus blackbugs that are seen here. Vaishno Devi is one of the religious places. Now this place, NGT, the National Green Tribunal, has put up a cap of not allowing more than 50,000 visitors per day. So that's one of the important developments at this location. You have Banasura Sagar Reservoir. Now this reservoir is located in Kerala. Important because it's the India's only and the largest floating solar power plant that has come up in the region of Wayanad. So very, very important. Some of the locations which I'm saying very important are indeed important for your 2019 examination per se. Bengaluru is one of the major cities which has got its own logo. This is B and U, which are marked in red color. So it's a unique logo, B and U, that has been designed. Neknampur Lake is one of the largest floating treatment wetland, which is located in the region of Telangana. This has been a joint effort of an NGO, which is Dhruvansh, working in the region of Hyderabad. So very, very important location. Ghodazari Wildlife Sanctuary is a new wildlife sanctuary which has been approved in the region of Chandrapur. So Chandrapur lies in the Brahmapuri forest area of Maharashtra. So very, very important location. You have 12 locations which have been part of the iconic tourist site. Now many of those you must be familiar with the name and the location. So let's say Ajanta and Ellora, you all know it's Maharashtra. Some of the less known ones and important would be Mahabodhi Temple. Then you have Khajuraho, Colva Beach, you have the Somnath and Dholavira. So those are some of the important locations. The location and the state you must be familiar with very carefully. Chilika Lake, it's an important location. We have been covering this off and on, but this time this has been in news because it has been considered as the single largest habitat for Irrawaddy dolphins. Now Irrawaddy dolphins, a population of nearly 150 plus such dolphins have been seen in Chilika Lake, and Chilika Lake is therefore important location. Kremapuri, very, very important, a location in Meghalaya, which is the world's longest sandstone cave that has been discovered. The previous record was held by the cave from Venezuela. So this is close to the region of Mysoram in Sora district. So very, very important. The next is Teen Murti Chowk. Now this has been renamed after the Battle of Haifa, which took place in 1918. And this chowk was basically the Teen Murti Haifa Chowk, which was it was previously called as. It was based on the name of the Israeli city Haifa, where Indian soldiers came in for the war memorial. The next is the holy pilgrimage sites, which are known as Pavitra Tirth Sthal. So you have most of the Tirth Sthal that are located in the region of Uttar Pradesh, of which Barsana, Govardhan, Baldev are very, very important locations. The sale of meat and liquor has been totally banned from these regions, and therefore they are called as the Pavitra Tirth Sthal. The next is the Ikupaka village. Now this village is located in Andhra Pradesh. It's important because you have the traditional toys which are made by the local artisans which are given a GI tag. Now GI tag, as we have already talked about, is a geographical indication tag which shows that a certain thing is unique to a certain area. So we have covered some of the very important GI tag locations in our previous classes. So just check that out. Also, the wood that is used for these toy making is from the Ankudikara, which is a specific tree native to that area. You have the Shamli district in Uttar Pradesh, which has been added as a new district to the NCR region or the National Capital Region of Delhi. So again, very, very important. As of now, there were 22 districts. This is a new district which has been added from Uttar Pradesh, a highly important reference even for your case studies. If you are having a question on, let's say, regional planning or urban expansion, urbanization, the process of urbanization, this topic becomes really, really important for your case studies as well. Agathi, you have the India's first runway on a sea bridge that has been developed in Lakshadweep. So again, a very important development in the region of Lakshadweep. So it's in Lakshadweep, the island of India. The next is Kolleru Lake. Kolleru Lake, you have the Attapakka Bird Sanctuary, and here there is a festival which is mainly for the pelican birds. So it's called as the Pelican Festival that is celebrated here. It's among one of the largest freshwater lakes of India, and more than 5,000 species, 5,000 pelican birds are seen here. Shakti Sthala in Karnataka is again important. It's one of the world's largest solar power plants located in Pavagarh. So Shakti Sthala is important in Karnataka. The next is Kote Kere Lake. Kote Kere Lake lies in the region of Karnataka. Now this lake is important because you have the tallest national flag that has been hoisted here. It is nearly 110 meters tall. The previous locations with the highest flags were Pune with 107 and Attari border with 105. So again, an important location coming up with your Independence Day, this becomes an important location. So those were some of the 20 important locations that we have covered as of now. We'll be covering many more locations in the upcoming class, and definitely before your mains, you would have the 10 important sets for the map location. I believe most of the locations for your examination would be covered through it, and also those who have been sending the test papers, I have been providing the feedback regularly. Those who have not sent in till yet, please keep on regularly sending your tests so that you can have ample of feedback before your examination is there. Have a wonderful day ahead.